Hi, welcome back. We're going to go ahead and continue our discussion about our conic section. In the last section, we found the system to solve where the center was. And of course, we had to use our partials and look at the equations of their diameters and solve that to get the center. Now we want to find out what are the maximum and minimum values. So before we do that, let's look at what our shape looks like, our ellipse looks like. Now remember, this is a rotated ellipse. So when I'm looking for the maximum, we're not really going to find the maximum from the center. What we're really going to find out is where the maximum values occur. And where those occur, like if here's my center, if I'm looking at my ellipse, where does my maximum value occur? Up top. Where does my minimum value occur? On the bottom. So there's my maximum, but you gotta be careful, this is going up and down. This would be like my maximum y, and this would be like my minimum y. Well, we know from experience that this is where dy from last year, dy would equal 0. And of course, in the minimum, the change in y values would equal 0. But I also have another maximum minimum, but in terms of my x's. This is why the partials become so important for us. I can find my maximum x value. So right over here, this would be where my max x would be. And that, of course, is where my change in x would be 0, if we think about in terms of last year. And over here, this is our minimum x value. In other words, where our change in, again, where our change in x is 0, or where the slope does not exist. So when we're looking for the maximum minimums, we're not necessarily looking for the maximum distance on the vertices, but what are the maximum values. Remember, that's what partials do. We're only interested in the x direction. We're only interested in the y direction. So when we're solving this, so let's take a look. So we are obviously going to need our partials again, and that's again where we take our derivative. So if I find my partial with respect to x, that's going to be 2x minus 8 plus 2y. And because I'm looking for maximum and minimum values, I would get that equal to 0. So we would get 2x minus 8 plus 2y equal to 0. And I can solve for y here pretty nicely. Y becomes, what's that become there? What's that? Negative x plus 4. So this point right, this is going to solve for my maximum in my x direction. This is going to solve for my maximums here. All right. So let's see here. And to solve it, I am just going to plug this into the original. And by plugging this in, we would get, we're just plugging for y, we would get x squared plus 4 times negative x plus 4 squared plus 8 times negative x plus 4 minus 8x plus 2x times negative x plus 4 plus 1, and that's going to equal 0. Now, I already did the nasty work for you because this is squaring. We're going to get two x values. X equals 3.19 and x equals 10.15. To get their corresponding y values, we can just plug it back into our function right here, and we will get y equals 0.813 here, and y would equal negative 6.15. So our two points would be at where we got, 3.19 and 0.813. Over here we would get 10.15, negative 6.15. So these would be where my partial with respect to x is 0. So let's go ahead and now find the partial with respect to y equals 0. where g of y is equal to 0. Remember, I'm looking for where my partial is equal to 0. So my partial with respect to y was 8y plus 8 plus 2x equal to 0. Now, I can solve for y here, but that's not going to be very nice. I'm going to solve for x instead, and we get negative 4y minus 4. And all I'm going to do with this is I'm going to plug into, again, the original function. So into the original graph. And if we do that, we're going to plug it into here. We would get, what's that become? Let me see, we're going to square it. So we would get negative 4y minus 4 squared plus 4y squared and plus 8y minus 8 times negative 4y minus 4 plus 2 times negative 4y minus 4 times y plus 1 equals to 0. And again, I already did kind of the dirty work for you. I solved those, and you get the y values negative 4.407, and you would get y equals negative 0.927. And again, to get their corresponding x values, you just plug into here, and we get 13.627 and negative 0.294, and so we get the points 13.627, negative 4.407, and over here we're going to get, this should be x, negative 0.294, and negative 0.927. Ooh, there's our other 2 points. And so when I look at this now, okay, I'm going to get the following points, and I'm just going to kind of graph it, nothing to scale. 3.19, so let's go 3.19, and positive 0.813, so there's 1 point. We'll call that point A, so I'll call that point A. 10.15, well, way over here, there's 10.15. Negative 6.15, and we'll call this point B. Over here, 13.627, negative 4.407, nothing drawn on the scale. We'll call that point C. And over here, 0.2 and negative 0.9, I guess there we go, point D. And I can get my center. It's going to be kind of like where they meet, so if you want to try to draw that, they're going to kind of, if you go counter cross right here, you can get your center, and we're going to draw this. Now, remember, this is a maximum value, so it's going to look like this. This is a minimum, so it's going to be curving in. And you can kind of, missed it, see what the ellipse will look like. Nothing perfect, okay? And there's our ellipse. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, right? So remember, this is the most, so like this point here, that's our most right. There's our most left. Our highest point, it looks like up here, remember, not drawn the scale, and of course our lowest point. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Go on to part 3, and we'll do something a little bit easier than this, okay? I'll see you then. Bye-bye.